हेलो फिजियोस, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू अवर चैनल फिजियो विद्यापीठ। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द मोड्स ऑफ टेंस। ओके, इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट टेंस एंड इट्स पैरामीटर्स अलोंग विद इट्स वेरियस इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स एंड द प्रिंसिपल ऑन विच द टेंस मॉडलिटी इज बेस्ड। ओके, सो माई नेम इज विजय कुमार एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। देर आर 5 modes of tense, which are: the first one is high tense or conventional tense, second is low tense or acupuncture like tense, the third one is brief tense or it is called intense tense or it is also called brief intense tense, and the fourth one is the burst tense, while the last one is the modulated tense. Okay, so in this video we will go through all these 5 modes of tense. First of all, we will study about conventional tense or high tense. What is the meaning of these two words? The word conventional means which is most oftenly used. So, we can say that conventional tense or high tense is the type of tense which is used very frequently in our physiotherapy clinics. And why it is written as high tense? It is based on the term frequency. High signifies the frequency. So, it is high tense, so frequency will be high, which is about 80 to 120 hertz. Okay, so which is high frequency. Okay, so you can write along me. So, we can say second is the intensity. If the frequency is high, then the intensity will be low. So, intensity is 12 to 30 milliampere, so which is low intensity. Another is, the third is duration, that for how much duration we need to apply this particular tense. If duration is usually 20 to 60 minutes, okay, 20 to 60 minutes, okay, which is a long duration. Then is the pulse duration. What is the pulse duration? This is pulse duration. From this to this is pulse width. Okay, pulse width, and it is also called the pulse duration. That for how much time the current is coming. You can see the current is coming, then it is not coming. Current is again coming, not coming, coming. So it is repeated alternatively. So pulse duration, also called the pulse width, it is 50 to 80 microseconds. Okay, 50 to 80 microseconds. Before moving to the fifth point, we need to understand that two things. As you know that the pain modulation can be either by pain gate theory or it can be by the descending pain suppression. So, pain gate theory or descending pain suppression or opioid mechanism. Okay, so whether the pain gate theory will be used or the descending pain suppression will use, it depends on the intensity factor. Low frequency use the low intensity, use the pain gate theory. Okay, while the high intensity use the descending pain suppression pathway. Okay, so now in our next modes, you can just see the intensity and find out whether the descending pain suppression or the pain gate theory is being utilized for the pain modulation. And why it is so? It is due to the fact that the pain gate theory have a beta fiber which have a large diameter. Okay, so it is stimulated even at a low intensity, while A, delta and C fiber have less diameter which need a high intensity to get stimulated to activate the descending pain suppression. So in analgesia there are 3 points. Analgesia is by pain gate theory. Second is, it is short lasting. Okay, it lasts for a short period of time. and it is a fast onset. Okay, fast onset. So if we want a fast onset of the pain modulation, or we want to decrease the pain in less time, we can use the analgesia method, that is high tense, which have a fast onset. Okay, it is used mostly in acute conditions. Acute conditions, and in acute condition the pain is usually high, so we need a fast onset. That is why we are using the high tense in the acute condition. Then is electrode placement and the sensation. Electrode placement can be at motor point or trigger point or we can say it can be at the acupuncture point. Okay, and the last point which we need to discuss is sensation. The sensation is a comfortable paresthesia sensation, which means a comfortable pin or needle-like sensation is there. So we can write as comfortable paresthesia. Okay, so this was whole about the mode of tense, in particularly the conventional or high tense. High tense means high frequency, it means intensity will be low, and low intensity means pain gate theory will be used. You can just put this thing into a box at the corner of your page so that you can always remember it. Okay, so high tense means high frequency, and if frequency is high then intensity is low. Low intensity means pain gate theory will be used. Duration is 20 to 60 and pulse duration is, or pulse width is 50 to 80 microsecond. Analgesia is by pain gate theory, which is short lasting and a fast onset. Electrode placement can be at motor point, trigger point or acupuncture point, and comfortable paresthesia and uses in acute condition. So this was about the high tense. Now we will study about low tense. So now we will study about the second mode, which is acupuncture like or the low tense. It is a misconception that the word acupuncture means to use it at the acupuncture points. No, it is not like that. Okay, so we will study it under these 8 headings and let's get started. So you can see that the word low means related to frequency. So the frequency is 2 to 5 hertz. Okay, if frequency is low, definitely intensity will be high. So intensity is greater than 30 milliampere, which is 2 or above the motor threshold. What is the meaning of this thing? It is saying that the intensity should be up to the motor threshold, so there can be a mild muscle contraction scenes. Yes, in the low tense it is desirable to get the muscle contractions by using tense. Okay, then we will move toward the duration, which is less than the conventional tense, which is about 30 to 40 minutes, while the pulse duration or pulse width is about 150 to 300 microsecond. Then the important is analgesia. Analgesia, it depends upon intensity. You can see intensity is high. I can write it here. High means descending pain suppression or opioid mechanism. So analgesia is by descending pain suppression or the opioid mechanism. And it is short lasting or long lasting? It is long lasting. Okay, and either it is rapid onset or a later onset, you can say it is a long onset. It requires long onset of analgesia. Electrode placement, the electrode are directly placed over the myotome related to that particular area. Myotome related to painful area. Okay, so next is our sensation. Sensation consists of two things. Here we can say it is paresthesia along with plus muscle twitch. Okay, muscle twitch which is desirable in the low tense. Okay, and it is used in the chronic conditions. Chronic condition. So as you can see the graph, intensity is slightly higher than the high tense, while the pulse duration is longer. You can see pulse duration is longer and intensity is also high as compared to the high tense. So you can simply say that low tense is mostly used in chronic condition. It is our second choice. Okay, simply we can say, because if a patient do not respond to the high tense, or we can say he do not get the relief of pain by high tense, we switch to the low tense, that is, it may have a chronic condition. Okay, so this was all about the second mode, which is acupuncture tense or the low tense. Now we will study about brief tense. So now we will study about the third mode of the tense, which is brief tense, also called brief intense or the intense tense. Okay, it is a newly developed mode of tense. Okay, so now we will study about it. Here the frequency is high, that is, it ranges from 125 to 250 hertz. Okay, frequency is high. Also the pulse duration is 200 to 250 microsecond, and its duration of application is about 15 minutes. Now before telling intensity, I just want to make you clear about another term, which is hyperstimulation analgesia. Okay, hyperstimulation analgesia. In this type of tense, it is usually developed during the wound debridement or during the surgeries. Okay, and here you can see that though the surgery is going or wound debridement is going, definitely it will be pain. Also, we are applying the currents. Okay, so there occur a hyperstimulation, which then give a analgesic effect, that is, it relieve the pain. Okay, so here the intensity is high. Okay, intensity is high and its value is about 20 to 50 milliamperes. Okay, 20 to 50 milliamperes, that is a high intensity. Then analgesia, as the intensity is high, so high intensity stimulate the descending pain suppression pathway, okay, or the opioid mechanism. Then the two other things which are here is that the effect is short lasting. Yes, it is short lasting and it is rapid onset. Okay, rapid onset of pain relief. Why we need the rapid onset? Because during the wound debridement or surgeries, There is a condition where the person is in pain. Okay, so definitely we need a rapid pain relief, which is given by brief tense. And then the electrode placement. Okay, electrode placement, when we are using it for the wound debridement or surgeries, we place it proximally. Okay, proximally. Also, it can be placed at while in other condition, it is placed at acupuncture or and motor, also at trigger points. Okay, trigger points. And here the sensation is, it is a bee stinging like sensation. Bee stinging like sensation. And the use, I have told you that it is used for wound debridement. Used for wound debridement and surgeries. Okay. Where we need the rapid pain relief. Another important point is that for this type of test, we use a local stimulator, which means that the current is applied at a particular location, okay, and each locus is given a current for about 30 seconds, okay, 30 seconds at this location, then at this location. So here we use a locus stimulator, okay. Again, we will just summarize it. It is a high intensity and frequency is also high, okay. Duration is 15 minutes, and here if the person says that he has not any reduction in the pain, then we can add 2-3 minutes, okay, plus 2 or 3 minutes, but not more than this, okay. This is only when the person says that there is not much reduction in pain, okay. So we can just add 2 or 3 minutes, okay. So this was whole about the brief tense. So now we will study about the burst tense. It is also called the pulse train tense. What is the meaning of it? You can see the graph. This is one stimuli, this is second stimuli, and this is third stimuli. Okay, this is one stimuli, second and third stimuli. Here several stimuli are grouped together to form a single package, which is received by the patient as a single stimuli, and it can have 1 to 10 stimuli, but here we are having 3 stimuli, okay. So the name pulse train stimuli is due to this, because it have a train of impulses which are paired together to form a single pulse, okay. So now another important thing is that this type of tense, that is the burst tense, have feature of both the tense, that is high tense as well as low tense. It have a high frequency, that is 50 to 100 hertz, that is high frequency, and you will see that this is the feature of high tense. Now what is the feature of low tense? Low tense have low frequency, but the intensity is high. So intensity is high here, high intensity. So it have both the feature of low frequency, low tense as well as the high tense, okay. It is the main. Then we will move toward the duration. Simply it is the 20 to 30 minutes, okay. Then the pulse duration, it is 50 to 200 microseconds. Then the analgesia, it is same as the low tense, okay. It is descending pain suppression or opioid mechanism. Then it is long lasting. Then it have a long onset, but this long onset is relatively earlier as to the low tense. So we can write as it is earlier than low tense, which is its first advantage over the low tense. So if somebody asks that why we prefer the burst tense over the low tense, it is the first thing, because it have a longer onset, but it is relatively earlier than to the low tense. Then it is other important thing is the electrode placement, which is over the myotome, which is related to the area. Then sensation is paresthesia along with plus muscle contraction, along with muscle contraction. And the second advantage is that here the muscle contraction is comfortable, which was a muscle twitch in low tense, which was uncomfortable for patient. So it is comfortable. Then low tense. And last is the use. It is used in chronic conditions. Okay, so these are the main things. Now to remember, you need to remember these two points, that analgesia is of a long onset but relatively less than low tense, which is its first advantage, and second is the muscle contraction is a comfortable contraction. It is not a muscle twitch, which was in the low tense and it was uncomfortable. So this was whole about the burst tense. Now we will study about the modulated tense. So now we will study about last mode of test, which is a modulated test. I have also discussed about this mode in the parameters of test, okay, the previous one video. Okay, so in modulated test there are three parameters, as we know. First is the amplitude, second is frequency, third is width. We can use the values according to our choice, okay, that is a preset value, because here the modulation is cyclic. It starts from 0, reaches up to the preset value and again come back to 0. So you can see this graph. The first graph shows the amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation means, you can see here the amplitude is minimum or the 0. It increases to the preset value, again it come back to 0. After some time it again start increasing and again come to reach up to the preset value. So this is about the amplitude modulation, which is most commonly used. While there are some other machines in which we can modulate two or even all these three parameters of tense. The second one show the pulse, show the frequency modulation. Okay, it is a frequency modulation. Here frequency is less. Okay, less waves are going here. A large number of wave is going in a small time, so here frequency is high. It moves from 0 to preset value, again come to 0, then the preset value. So it is a frequency modulation, while this one is the pulse width modulation. So you can see here the pulse width is this, while here the pulse width is this. Okay, so it again increases from 0 to preset value, again come to 0, and so on. The main benefit is that there are no accommodation, okay, accommodation of the tissue is, of the nerves is prevented. Also here the important thing is to remember that as the amplitude decreases, the pulse width increases. As the amplitude decreases, the pulse width increases. Why? To give a more consistent energy per pulse, so that the main aim is that the total energy per pulse is maintained at a consistent level. How? As amplitude decrease, pulse width increase, and vice versa. When the amplitude increase, pulse width can decrease. Okay, it occurs when we modulate two variables, okay, that is amplitude as well as the pulse width. Okay, so this was whole about the mode of tense, in which we discussed about high tense, low tense, brief tense, burst tense, and last is the modulated tense. Okay, one another thing, in some books the diagram is like this. Okay, so it is a biphasic. Okay, in the parameters I have explained that the waveform can either be monophasic or can be biphasic. Okay, so don't get confused with the after say watching these three diagrams, that why are they not going in the lower phase. Okay, so I have drawn it in the monophasic way, while the some books also show it in the biphasic way. Okay, so keep studying, and I wish you a very good future ahead. Thank you to one and all.